What should I talk about today? People like it when I talk about stuff. Earth cycles? No. Quantum physics? Too deep. We're all connected. Ah, this should do. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another beautiful day. So today, guys, I'm gonna talk to you about the top 5 things you can do to help improve your riding. But first, let's have a look at some bikes. I'd like to preface this and inform you that this will be a moto vlogging style video. I've included timestamps in the description below if you wish to skip ahead to those topics. And if you're not already subscribed, hit that like and subscribe button to support me because it really helps with YouTube's algorithm so I can keep going and bring you more content. Also, I'd like to know in the comments below what you did to help improve your riding. Now let's get back to the ride.
What's up, brother? How you doing? What's happening? Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Is it brand new?
Yeah, I think I got it. Was it 3 weeks now?
Did you break it?
No, not yet.
Don't go fast.
Yeah, I know.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, you picked up a couple of bikes yourself too, right?
That one.
Yes.
I just went to Alaska and I rented the GS 750.
Yeah, yeah.
Love that bike.
Everyone starts somewhere, and I sure started as a beginner at some point. Whoa! That was terrible. You can see sort of all the improvements I've made since. Now, a lot has to do with that, with the first tip that I have for you. And that is, take advanced classes beyond the MSF course. I feel like the time spent with all the money on mods, not enough goes into proper riding education. The investment I personally made with the Yamaha Champ School
got me to where I'm at here. Faster? Yes. Safer? F*** yeah.
Yo, the body's coming off more. Yeah, really? You can see I'm trying to exaggerate, you know.
Ramp?
Yeah.
Which one?
Right here.
Okay. Here?
Yeah, right here.
Go. See you shaking, buddy.
Yamaha Champ School has changed my riding considerably. I'm gonna put links below and to the top right of your screen so you guys can check that video out. I think it's worth every penny improving on your skill set. especially if you live in an area like I do, where you're surrounded by beautiful mountains. And number two on my list would have to be vision. You always want to be scanning ahead, even though you're following a rider in front of you. I'm looking way ahead of the rider in front right now, and that really gives you an optimal choice in your lines. Now that becomes more apparent when you're going at a faster rate of speed. So if you look at the ground, it appears that the road is going much faster. Never focus on what's in front of you, but instead look further ahead.
See me earlier. The earlier you can see me, the smoother you'll be.
Keep your eyes a little bit sooner. See the amount of room you got to brake.
Eyes brake, body throttle. Looking further ahead is not only safer, but faster. And the third thing on my list would be gripping the tank with your knees. Most often, beginner riders tend to have a death grip on the handlebars. And I could say that I'm guilty of that, especially when I started out. Now, it's probably a natural human reaction to grip on for dear life. But the problem with that is now your body is taking all the bumps on the road. And so, what happens then is the bike becomes unstable. And you don't want that, especially going through tough terrain. Gripping the tank also provides more stability. It also helps you with proper body position. So have a loose hand grip and hold on to your tank with your knees. Now, body position is another topic that we could really get deep into, but I'll save that for a different time. Brakes, tires, brake pads, tire pressure. You always want to check that your fluids are topped up and you're running the right tire pressure as well. And this is another thing that I'm guilty of, not checking my tire pressures. Makes a significant difference when you're running the correct tire pressures when you're out here on the road. I've also got a tool that's used to indicate wear on your tires. Speaking of which, my R9T needs a set of new tires. So I'll leave a link of that tool in the description below. I think 30% of your bike's handling characteristics has to do with the tires. So make sure you check them. Whatever you guys do, don't get too complacent, because you're always gonna have areas to improve. I mean, every time I go out riding, just as today, I'm constantly developing my motorcycling skill set. Awesome riding.
I'm like, you're too fast. You're so good. You can go faster than 60.
Hey, buddy. Oh, you're so cute. You are so cute.
Oh my gosh, I'm so happy you got to see llamas! Those of you who've been with me for a while know that I love animals. I think sometimes more so than humans. I'm always covering my brakes no matter what. Now the purpose of that is to reduce my margin of error should I be involved in an emergency braking situation. It goes well in line with trail braking. You want to let the corner come to you, come in at a slower entry speed, and then smash it on the exit. See, I'm braking right now, even way beyond the tipping point, until I'm happy with my speed and direction. So I'm always trail braking in every ride. And always braking lighter and longer. It just reduces my margin of error should anything occur. Gosh, this canyon is so fun. That was a perfect example right there of trail braking. Lighter, longer. Now as soon as I see my exit, that's when I'll get on the throttle. And I'm also maintaining my throttle throughout the corner as well. Another good example of trail braking right there. That was awesome.
Is this your first time on this bike here?
Yeah.
How does it feel?
Feels great. Yeah. It handles the corners pretty graciously.
Really well balanced. But just wait till you can really get on it and can really start revving it out. It's probably, you're probably happy in third gear through most of it.
Yeah, right.
Top of the rev range. And just be able to sneak up and down the gears.
I'm still getting used to the quick shifter, so I haven't used it much really, but I could tell that it wants to be up there in third gear, but I can't go beyond 6,000 yet because of the break-in period. Can't wait till I cross that threshold. So far, yeah, man, I'm so happy with this, dude.
So, as I was changing my GoPro battery, we noticed a car using up both lanes on this blind corner. Instinctively, stay in your lane was yelled out. The driver then stopped in the middle of the road and proceeded to reverse. Here's what happened next.
Stop the bike coming down, you're gonna crash him. Stay on this side, buddy. Think about somebody else, that's all.
Yeah, just stay the right away, man. There's one corner.
You can feel somebody.
Okay. Yeah.
I think I saw the Portuguese come out. He's a lover, not a fighter. Guys, I'm ending the vlog here. Hope you found these tips useful, and if you did, do give me a like. I'd really appreciate that because it helps the YouTube algorithm. And also subscribe. Be sure to keep those sidestands up. Peace!